Hi everyone. This video tells about the distinction between the lawn waiver and the lawn write-off. There are a lot of debates which is happening over a period of time. It's the consequences of lawn write-off and lawn waiver. So hope this video will clarify the concepts of lawn waiver and lawn write-off. The reality of news in the recent newspapers. Recent news is disclosed that RBI writing off loans worth rupees 68,000 crores from 50 willful defaulters, including fugitive businessmen like Mehul Choksi and Vijay Mallya. People were often confused with the news in the newspapers. People were misconceptualized. Loan written off means simply write off loan from those borrowers. And there are a lot of poor people in the country. Their loans are serviced in a correct way, but these richer fraud offenders, they categorized as fugitive economic offenders by the court, and their loan were written off. It's simply cheating, something like that people were perceived. But this is a fact that banks simply written off that loans as NPA, and the bank can start legal proceedings against those borrowers, and now it's already started the recovery proceedings. Bank can recover the figures which is written off from the balance sheet of the bank right now. There are two fugitive businessmen in India. Is court already declared these are the two fugitive businessmen in India, Vijay Mallya and Nirav Modi. And Vijay Mallya already declared fugitive businessman quite 5 or 6 months ago, and now Nirav Modi also, Mumbai court, special court declared Nirav Modi as fugitive businessman. And both persons, they are being facing with the legal fighting with the legal consequences nowadays. And the country, Government of India has passed an act, Fugitive Economic Offenders Act 2018. This act was enacted in 2018. The act should provide for measures to deter fugitive economic offenders from evading the process of law in India by staying outside the jurisdiction of Indian court. The Fugitive Economic Offenders Tag allows Indian probe agencies to confiscate and attach properties of the accused, and is targeted at those who flee India to escape prosecution. The first person to be declared a fugitive economic offender under the act was Vijay Mallya, who is accused of fraud and defaulting on the bank loans to the tune of rupees 9,000 crore. And the next was Nirav Modi. The two persons were declared as fugitive businessmen under the Fugitive Economic Offenders Act 2018. And we can go a little detail with the loan waiving and the loan write-off. Loan waiving simply waiving of loans, loan waiving is a policy decision of the government or RBI to some sectors. This loan waiving is allowed to some sectors like agriculture or farmers or marginalized people in the society. They are facing difficulty to repayment of loan. This is the government decision to waive those loans. Loans once waived, these borrowers are not needed to repay that loans, and the banks will not get any funds from such loans. But the banks are compensated by the RBI and government, sufficiently compensated by RBI and government, and the banks will not lose any funds while this waiving process. And who are the beneficiaries of loan waivers in India? Studies show that big and mid-sized farmers are one who gain the most from farm loan waivers. Scholars point that the loan waivers during the one loan cycle prompt bank to reduce credit outlay for small and marginal farmers during the next loan cycle. The cost of this waiving shall be borne by the RBI and Government of India. And some details about the loan write-off. Loan write-off is a tool used by the banks to clean up their balance sheet. There is a concept called non-performing asset. When a loan will be categorized as non-performing asset means when a loan is like 90 days default, 90 days no interest or principal amount payment by the particular borrower, the loan is categorized as NPA. For those NPAs, three consecutive default in the payment of interest and principal amount by the borrower, that particular loan is categorized as that particular loan is to be written off as NPA. So three consecutive quarters, that means 270 days default of a particular loan should be written off as per the Basel Committee reforms that was being implemented in the banks. So the bank will write off those loans in which the three consecutive quarters in which the principal and interest is overdue. So that way, the 68 crores last week, the banks have written off the 68 crores because of these of course these 68 crores includes Nirav Modi's and Vijay Mallya's loans, but the banks is able to recover these loans because these people, these frauds people's assets were kept as security for getting these loans. So the bank can recover recover the loans by selling of these assets. So how write-off helps the banks? So suppose a bank disposes a loan of rupees 1 crore to some borrower and is required to make a 10% provision for it. So the bank can set aside another 10 lakhs without waiting for the borrower to default on repayment. If the borrower makes a bigger default, say rupees 50 lakhs, the bank can write off additional rupees 40 lakhs, mentioning it as expense in the balance sheet in the year of default. But as the loan is written off, it also frees rupees 10 lakhs originally set aside for provisioning. That money is now available to the bank for business. There is an additional benefit of writing off bad loans. The loan write-off does not take away the bank's right to recovery from the borrowers through legal means. After writing on the bad loan, the bank can start legal proceedings to recover the loans. And after that, the bank's balance sheet looks a rosy picture. So I can conclude with this slide, this loan waiver and loan write-off. Loan waiver is quite different from the writing of a loan, as it is the cancellation of recovery or refraining from claiming the dues. It's fully written off. That means the banks will not get that loan's repay back, but the banks are compensated by the government and RBI. In similar terms, banks will be completely give up on such loans and no recovery will be made. While in case of write-off, recovery can be made. Waiving of loan is a relief that is normally provided to farmers who are in severe distress due to abnormal conditions such as crop failures, poor monsoon, floods, earthquake, drought, etc. But these are conditions which are beyond the control of the borrower, so that the banks, with the permission of the, I mean, with the instructions of the RBI and government, the banks go for the waiving of loans. But write-off is under a different bank can recover those loans with the legal recovery proceedings. So I hope you understand the distinction between loan waiver and loan written off. Thank you.